I'm getting a new computer.
Well, there it is. A big old freaking pile of stuff that will hopefully turn itself into a computer. I guess I got a little reading to do. I have to remember how to do this. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you. I'm going to hopefully get all the settings and all the software and all the shit that's in my old computer migrated over to this brand new spanky frickin' i7 quad core super overhead torque Fram Cordozel. And I'm going to have to repair a lot of guitars to pay for this pile of shit. Holy crap. Wish me luck. So because I want to transfer all this shiter from this system to the new one, the first thing I want to do is make sure that the C drive is virus-free. So we're going to do a scan. And while it's scanning, let's open up this box and see what the new box looks like. Well, I was gooched, but I found this inside floating around. Anyhow, that's the thing. Dude said I should put another fan in the front. How many fucking fans do you need in there? Christ, there's two already. And then I'm going to put a CPU, plus just a fan on the video card. I think it's fanned up. And then I took the sides off, which come off really easy, and the front comes off easy too. But we found this. Treated with volatile corrosion inhibitors. Keep this item corrosion free. Face opposite side to metal. Do not use with foodstuffs. Hazardous substances. What the hell is this stuff? Okay, anyway, this is all screws. Don't get a case that has those stupid, when they say it's, no hardware, it's all those clippy plastic pieces of shit. Don't get that. If you're building a computer, you'll be not happy. And then I undid, three little clips on the side. And the whole front just comes off. I like this. Does it really need a fan in the front? How much blowing and sucking can take place inside that box? This is nice. The fans have little speed selectors, low, medium, high, so you don't have to have them blazing. I'm sure there's a place to thread these out the backside where you can flick them. That's kind of cool. Looks pretty good, so I guess we gotta put the motherboard in the box. That would be the first thing to do. So I had to swap out the plate in the back, but with the one that came with the motherboard. But I'm also missing some standoff things inside, which I think are in that bag, so I gotta install those. And we're gonna get that guy in the box where it's safe. The reason I got Asus, or Asus, as one goof at the store was calling it, I don't know how you say it. But anyway, I got this because of the cool heatsink thing. Intel don't have that. Okay, motherboard's in, power supply's in. Now I gotta go read the motherboard book a little bit and see what it says about turning it on for the first time and all that shit. Shouldn't be too tough. And with a big breath, we drop the brain into it. Holy Christ, that always makes me nervous. Where is it? Core i7. This thing's gonna rock. Oh yeah, I had to mount the ringy thingy for the cooling fan. Now, they're telling me put the RAM in, put the cooling fan on next. But I think I gotta see, because I think it'll be tough to get the RAM in once the fan's in place. Let's look. Holy crap, would you look at this cooler? It looks like a rat out of a frickin' small import car. I think I gotta check this out, see if everything works the way it's supposed to. Well, as you can see, I'm up to my asshole in alligators here. This is like, it's like a model car kit. Remember when you were a kid and you built a model car? Except this model car comes in 9 different boxes from 9 different people, hoping that it's going to make a car. I think I'll get it. It's just a lot of baloney. Hopefully it will be powered up in the next edition. I'm going to probably do a part 2 on this one. Would you look at the frickin' fanage in there? This thing's going to blow every which way but loose. It better frickin' work. You get a video of me throwing this out the window. All that shit that I bought's in the box. This is a first for me, because there's no floppy. There is no IDE interface. Everything is SATA. SATA hard drive, SATA Blu-ray tray. That frickin' cooler just freaks me out. And 4 gigs of RAM. i7 quad core with some sort of crazy 1 gig dual monitor video card. Just so we're clear, this thing can actually run 3 video cards if it needs to, 6 frickin' monitors. Wouldn't that be unreal? And you can strap 2 video cards together to double up the power if you're into that sort of crazy nonsense. But okay, I'm going to read my book, read the motherboard thing over again, check all my connections, and then I might power it up tonight. But first I got to do this backup thing, and I got to show you this. This is how it's going to go. Okay, a couple things we got to do on the old system. First, we got to run this in the run thing. Okay, hold on. Now what I need to do is mark down all this info. It's not that critical, but it's critical that the C partition be at least that big. What's on my D drive, I have backed up. It's just about 300,000 songs, which is on another drive, so I don't really care about it. So on the new system, the new hard drive has to at least be that big, and it has to be NTFS. So that's the first little part of it. Just write all this down and make sure you sort of remember it for the new system. So I'm actually going to use something that's already in Windows to do this. So we go up to Start. We go, where the hell are you? Programming things, accessories, system tools. And, oh geez, I can't focus with the camera here. I need backup. There it is. Okay. So we're going to go through this whole thing, and we're going to go through it, and it's going to ask us if we can back up the entire computer. And that's what we're going to do onto an external USB drive. So I'm going to create a backup of this whole version of Windows XP, which I have the boot disk for, and the, you know, the product code and all that shit. So once I've created that backup, then we'll move over to the new system, and I'll explain briefly, and then I'm going to send this up to YouTube. On the new system, I'm going to install Windows XP, just like I normally would. Then I'll put all the drivers in for the new video card and everything, get everything working the way it's supposed to. Now once all the hardware is set with Windows XP, I'll take this backup thing that I just made over there, and I'll go to accessories, backup, and I'll take everything off that hard drive, all my programs, all my settings, all my icons, all my shit, and migrate it over to this version of XP. It will ask me for the key code again, no big frickin' deal. But wish me luck, guys. This is how to do it. I don't know how you do it. I think you can move up to Windows 7 and still do this, sort of. Vista, we don't care about. That should be flushed in the toilet. So anyway, that's the deal. Using a function that's already in Windows, I'm going to get everything off my old system that I love all on to my new system, which is going to go a frick of a lot faster. Wish me luck. That'll be part 2. all my backup completed. I've got this thing standing by, ready to put power to it. Keyboard, mouse, and monitor are hooked up. Cool thing about this is that this rig isn't dead yet. It's just on its way out. It's just slow and shitty and old. And so I'm not going to be crippled or anything. But I think I'm going to try and boot this up. Cross your fingers. Starting up for the first time. Be sure all switches are off. I'm not putting the fucking cover back on in case it doesn't work. Okay, turn on the devices. The monitor's on. I have no... Okay, system power. Wish me luck, folks. Stand by for a smoke show or sweet FA. Tough to say. Well, there's a couple of lights going on inside. I'm going to hit the button. Oh. Looking good. Let's see what happens. Well, it came on and we got this. So I think I got to go into setup. Hold on. Excellent sign. It recognizes the optical drive and the hard drive. What I need to do now is turn the IDE off and make it SATA boot. Well, I put in a Windows CD and there's a whole pile of shit going on, but I got a shitty looking screen. And I'm pissed with that. I know what's gonna happen.